All right, John Stiegelmeier, the head coach of the Jackrabbits, has joined us after 11th-ranked SDSU picks up a 52-24 win at number 12, Western Illinois. And from start to finish, I know there were a couple of hiccups along the way, but this was a pretty complete game. You played offense, defense, and special teams.
Complete game, and a lot of guys stepped up. A lot of guys made some plays that when they're called on, really proud of this football team to go on the road. Missouri Valley has some travel frustrations and come down here and put it all behind you and play a great game.
In that first quarter, you have the interception that leads to a touchdown for them. You miss a couple of scoring chances, it would appear, and settle for a field goal. 10-10 after one, yet you felt like you left some points on the field in the first quarter.
Well, you know, you, anytime you give them a touchdown like we did on the interception, you got to think you got to stop them, but then you also have to think, you know, those are free points. And so our guys played with confidence the whole game. And it just, you know, they take the field offense, defense, like you said, special teams, and expect to help win a football game.
Couple of critical moments in the game I want to bring up. First off, that drive at the end of the second quarter, not only to put you up 24-17, but the way you used the clock so there was less than a minute left. That was a critical drive to take the lead going into the locker room.
It was, and credit Coach Eidsness with his play calls. Coach Eck is really in tune to the clock and timeouts and stuff. He does a great job of hinting around at the right time, going to the locker room with momentum and confidence and just expecting to come out and play the same game and win a football game.
Up 7 in the third quarter, Western Illinois punch. You're deep in your own territory, 3rd and long. Christian is scrambling from his own end zone and almost throws it up, and Winicky makes a play on the Western sideline for a first down. That was a critical play. You score a few plays later, but that was huge.
That was huge. Jake Winicky is a phenomenal student athlete, and on the football field, he's made so many plays for us, the one-handed, the two touchdowns. I mean, he's a special kid.
He certainly is. And Marquise Lewis getting into the act with a couple of big plays here, 2 touchdown catches. I'm sure you are proud of him.
I am. He helped break us down at the end in the locker room. He plays with great energy. He's had some frustrations at times, but today he rose up. And you know, those guys, they just believe, they work hard. They don't get all the throws because of those other two guys we got, but he made do today.
And twice in the third quarter against a team that only turned it over a handful of times all year, you force turnovers. Jordan Brown strips the ball away from their star wideout, Acklin. Rosaboom jumps on it, and then Christian Rosaboom also came up with the INT. Turnovers are critical, but especially against a team that's so good at taking care of the ball as Western Illinois is.
Yeah, that, you know, again, we practice turnovers, turnover circuit, and credit Jordan Brown with the, you know, as you did with the fumble. A forced fumble, and then just hustle, gets it. And then Christian Roseboom made a phenomenal interception on the overthrow. Really proud of him and the way our guys played on defense.
2 straight weeks to go on the road and play nearly complete football games, especially the defense. In the second half of both these games, the defense was superb.
They were. And you know, against a team like Western who does so many things, you really want to dumb it down. You want to make sure you're lined up right. You want to keep the ball in front of you. And I think we did that more in the second half. And our guys played, like you said, some really good defense.
Well, big win for the program on the road at Western Illinois. And now 2 straight weeks at home. Next Saturday, the Dakota Marker will be on the line as North Dakota State makes the trek down I-29. And a sellout crowd expected at Dana J. Dykow Stadium. And an atmosphere I know that you're very much looking forward to in 7 days' time.
Our whole football program's looking forward to it. And we've asked our fans to step up. We've asked our anybody that loves the Jackrabbits to be there, and they're going to be there. And I'm excited about that, more excited for administration that people honored them. Look forward to a great game. But right now we're going to enjoy this one.
Congratulations, Coach, and we'll see you at the airport in Moline.